Hello, I'm Isabel González de León. I'm a PhD student from the UPC in Spain, and I will present a study on the influence of geometric and material nonlinearities on the global stability of stainless steel frames. Stainless steel is a corrosion-resistant alloy with excellent mechanical properties, appearance, and residual value. The mechanical behavior of stainless steel is considerably different from carbon steel. Carbon steel shows a clear linear behavior up to the yield stress, while stainless steel exhibits a non-linear stress-strain behavior even for low strain values and is characterized by a high ductility and a considerable strain hardening. There are many types of stainless steel depending on their chemical composition. In construction, one of the most used is the austenitic stainless steel, which has a more pronounced nonlinearity, is very ductile, and has an important strain hardening. Current standards for structural stainless steel, as the Eurocode 3 Part 1-4, are based on carbon steel standards, and they provide some supplementary rules for considering the material nonlinearities into the design of the cross sections and members. Regarding a structural global analysis, the current Eurocode 3 Part 1-4 does not provide any supplementary rules to account for the effect of material nonlinearities and does not permit to use global plastic analysis. But, as highlighted by recent studies, it is necessary to consider material nonlinearity effects on the design of sway frames, since this type of linearities increments the degradation of the stiffness of the frame, causing greater deformations and increasing second-order effects. Based on the design approach available for carbon steel sway frames, the team of the Imperial College proposed a method for estimating second-order plastic effects on stainless steel single-story frames without the need of carrying out a geometrical and material nonlinear analysis with imperfections, also known as GIMNIA analysis. The method consists of performing a first-order analysis with material nonlinearities, MNA, in which sway effects, horizontal actions, initial sway imperfections, are amplified by a factor referred to as modified K-amp. This amplification factor depends on the modified alpha crit. The modified alpha crit is calculated as the product of a coefficient Y, whose value is 0.8 for austenitic stainless steel single-story frames, the ratio of the secant stiffness at the design load level to the initial lateral stiffness of the structure obtained from a first-order plastic analysis, MNA, which accounts for the average reduction of the stiffness due to material nonlinearities, and the elastic buckling load factor, alpha crit. According to the team of the Imperial College, this modified approach is valid for frames with modified alpha crit greater than 3. For very sway frames, it is better to carry out a second-order plastic analysis. Recently, the Imperial College team has extended this plastic design method to more complex frames and types of stainless steel. But at the time of submission of this communication, the assessment of the approach was about numerical results of austenitic stainless steel I-section single-story frames with fixed-ended supports and loadings applied at the top of the columns. Therefore, this study aims to extend the numerical analysis to austenitic portal frames with different spans, bonding, and loading conditions, and study the applicability of the proposal by calibrating the Y factor. The numerical study is based on experimental results obtained at the UPC and presented at previous congresses. Very shortly, there were 4 austenitic stainless steel portal frames with 4 tubular cross sections tested under vertical and horizontal loadings. The loading was applied in 2 steps. At the first step, 2 concentric vertical forces were applied at the beam, and during the second step, vertical forces were held on and the horizontal force was applied by imposing the displacement of the column supports. Tests to characterize the stress strain behavior of the stainless steel were also conducted. The numerical models using beam type elements and shed type elements were validated by comparing the results obtained from a gymnia analysis with the experimental ultimate loads, deflections, and displacements. As shown, both numerical models are capable of accurately reproducing the experimental behavior for the frame. Discrepancies between the two numerical models are related to the more accurate geometric definition of the cross-sections allowed in shell element models. So, for the parametric study, bean-type finite elements available in Abacus were used. The problem with bean-type elements is that they cannot reproduce the local buckling phenomena. So finite element analysis can overpredict ultimate resistance and can lead to unsafe results. To limit the gymnia analysis, the capacity of the stainless steel bean-type elements has been limited using the CSM strain limit approach. The continuous strain method is a deformation-based method that considers the effect of strain hardening. This method uses a base curve that relates the maximum strain that a cross-section can achieve prior to local buckling to the relative local slenderness. The CSM strain limit approach consists of limiting the maximum strain obtained from a gymnia analysis to the CSM strain limit. Regarding material model, the two-stage Lambert-Osgood model was used. The values of the parameters correspond to the weighted average values obtained from tensile, flat, and corner coupons, also tested at the UPC. Sway imperfections were included in all analyses. Residual stresses and bow imperfections were also included in gymnia analysis. The parametric study was performed on 24 portal frames, similar to those tested, subjected to simultaneously applied vertical and horizontal loadings, with different head-to-length ratios, bondering conditions, fixed or pin-ended, position of the vertical loading at the top of the column or on the beam, and different horizontal to vertical loading ratios. All the frames had the same class 1 rectangular hollow cross-section. Cross-sections were oriented for bending about their major axis. The main results are presented below. The typical load displacement responses obtained from the different structural analyses show that the influence of geometric nonlinearities on the global behavior of the structure decrease as the horizontal force increase, while the effects of the material nonlinearity become more important. In addition, most of the study frames collapse as a result of instability, and only two frames, which were subjected to vertical loading applied on the beam, collapsed because they exceed the ultimate capacity of the cross-section. That is, for most of them, the ultimate load predicted by the gymnia analysis occurred before the CSM strain limit was reached, at the most critical section. Critical sections, normally located at the end of the columns, were subjected to significant bending moments. Finally, we evaluate the calibration of the modified K-amp factor. For this purpose, the required values of the Y factor at the modified alpha crit expression were determined for the 24 frames analyzed. Several first-order plastic analysis or MNA analysis with sway forces and amplified by modified K-amp factors were executed in an iterative process, until the drips at ultimate load obtained from the MNI analysis were equal to the drips obtained from the gymnia analysis. As shown, the mean value for this factor is 0.75, so the value of 0.8 proposed by the Dean of the Imperial College is accurate and safe. Here we can see that for the frame cases studied, the K-amp factor for carbon steel used with MNI analysis underpredicts the second-order plastic internal forces. However, the proposed modified K-amp factor with the y factor equal to 0.8 leads to safe predictions of second-order plastic internal forces. Besides, it should be noted that the modified approach seems to be accurate also for frames with modified alpha-crit less than 3, at least for the study cases. Only in one case, the 0.8 factor is quite unsafe. In this case, the collapse of the frame occurs due to a plastic collapse of the beam. Therefore, it can be concluded that it is only appropriate to use the modified KM approach in cases where sway is dominant. So, this study has extended the global plastic design approach to austenitic portal frames with different spans and bonding and loading conditions. The analysis of the results show that it is essential to consider the effect of material nonlinearity through the definition of the modified alpha-crit parameter. The MNI plus amplified sway effects approach seems to be appropriate also when modified alpha-crit is less than 3 for frames where sway modes were dominant. However, further research on a wider range of stainless steel frames with different alloys, ferritic and duplex, is necessary to adjust the value of the Y factor. Thank you very much for your attention.